Hi everyone, this is Wendy and welcome back to my channel. Today I'll be sharing my swatches and first impressions of these Rockwell watercolors that I received from Canada. So the ones I have here are the self-evolving range. Now that's the first time I've heard of that term in watercolors, but I believe that to describe the color separation and the granulating nature of these paints. So I have 12, which is the full range of their self-evolving paints, and I'm excited to swatch them out to see what they look like. So these paints, I believe, come in the one size, which is in 15 ml tubes. I really like the gold packaging. I think that's quite unique compared to other brands, and the pigment information is also listed on the back. So I'm going to be making the swatches today on my Etch-A-Sketchbook, which is 100% cotton cold pressed, and these swatches are going to be quite large, so I hope you enjoy larger swatches. So the first color I have is called Alexandria Diamond Purple. This one is a three pigment mix of PB29, PR122 and PBR6. So this color is really nice. It's a cool toned purple, and I'm adding in a bit of water to see the granulation a bit more. The next shade is called Palaba Diamond Blue. This is a two pigment mix of PB29 and PG7. I really like this color. It's a lovely deep and pigmented blue turquoise shade, which I think would be really good for seascapes to add some tonal variation into the depth of the water, as there is a lot of intensity to this color, and the color separation between the green and the blue is a lot more evident once the color has dried down. The next shade is called Royal Purple. This is a very vibrant, warm-toned purple, especially when compared to the first purple that we swatched. You can see that in the more lighter washes of color towards the bottom of the swatch. You can see more of that pink separation. Though what did confuse me was the pigment mix. On the label it says it's made up of PB17 and PG7, which if I'm not mistaken is essentially a blue and a green. So I'm not too sure how those two colors create this purple shade. The next shade is called Onat Diamond Yellow. This is a very natural looking green, similar to the color of moss or an olive green. This would be very useful for natural looking foliage where you are looking for a lot of granulation and color separation. And when I first saw this color, it reminded me a lot of Daniel Smith's Undersea Green. So I decided to do a comparison between the two, and I will insert a picture of them side by side now. So on the left we have Daniel Smith and on the right is Rockwell. You can see that while these two colors are not identical, they are very similar in both the granulation and the color separation. Out of the two, I actually prefer the Rockwell one more because I found it easier to build up the color intensity on that side. This next color is called Lima Green Brown, and it's a mix of PB29 and PY43. It looks like a natural yellow ochre shade with a green undertone to it. I would say overall the color separation isn't as obvious in this shade compared to the others, and it's a more natural and subtle color. The next shade is called Valentine Purple, and it's a three pigment mix of PW6, PR122 and PB29. To me this looks like a straight up lavender color, and it's more opaque compared to the other colors because of the white pigment that's used in this color. The next color is called Cleopatra Green. It's made up of PB17 and minerals. To me it looks like a cross between a Payne's Grey and a Perlene Green. It's a very deep and dark moody color which leans slightly on the cooler side, and I would say this is a nice substitute for a black. The next shade is called Obsidian Brown. It's a three pigment mix of PB29, PBR6 and PY43. In its mass tone you can see that it's almost black, but in a lighter wash when it's been diluted it has a bluish brown undertone to it, though very subtle. I would say on its own it looks like quite a neutral dark shade. Next we have Lapis Brown. This is a three pigment mix of PB29, PY65 and PO13. This is another dark shade that separates into blue and brown, but with a warmer, slightly reddish undertone to it. It looks like this may be the most heavily granulating swatch, but it could be because I've just added more water to the swatch compared to the others, and hence you get to see that granulation a little bit more. Next shade is Opal Yellow, a 3 pigment mix of PB29, P65 and PBR6. This to me looks like a more intense and saturated version of the Lima Green Brown, which I swatched in the first row, second from the right. I couldn't actually find any information on the pigment P65, so if you do know, please let me know in the comments below. The next shade is called Magic Wizard, and this color looks very different when it's wet compared to when it has dried down. So as I'm swatching this, you can see that it's a very rich, deep, reddish brown shade. But however, when it dries, it looks very different. It looks more like a fiery orange mixed in with a yellow and some blue separation. The colors used here are PB29 and PR3. PR3, I believe, is not a very commonly used red pigment, but it's a bright red which gives this color its fiery orange red intensity. This last color is called Morai Witch. This is made up of Tourmaline PR146. To be honest, I am not familiar with this pigment at all, but color-wise, I would describe it as a bright, vibrant, cool-toned rose shade mixed with a super granulating black. So I want to show you a very quick little piece that I did with these watercolors. It's very simple, but I think it really showcases how these colors perform. So here I've only used two colors, the Royal Purple and the Onat Diamond Yellow. And you can see as the colors start to separate, I end up with something that looks a lot more colorful, and it looks like I've used more colors than I actually have. So my first impressions of these paints, they are very fun and expressive to use. You can see that the color separation just creates a very lovely and unique effect. They are very vibrant and saturated, but in terms of light fastness, that is something that I haven't tested. Let me know if that's something you'd be interested in seeing, and if there is any other brands that you would like to see me swatch and review in the future, please let me know in the comments below. And I'll talk to you soon in the next video. Bye.